Hello, it's Aga from RVS Artist. So many of you always ask me to do the version of the video in Vue as well. So here it is. Today we'll be working on the materials for this bathroom scene in Vue. I've created a video about the basics of materials, so if you are a beginner and you haven't watched it yet, be sure to check it out first. As previously, the scene we'll be working on today is a part of our RVS Artist training, but Vue version. I put the link in the corner for your reference. Let's begin. Anyway, today I show you how to create materials for this scene in Vue. Today I show you how to create materials even if you don't have all needed maps, because it happens sometimes and we need to know how to work with what we have. Let's create Vue material. We'll start with the stone at the back, and I will use the same texture I've used in the Corona tutorial. I chose it because I like the variations across the image. Let's plug the bitmap to the diffuse slot. Next, I will make it gray using a color correction map, and later I will add some glossy reflections. I think it should be darker. Let's adjust the RGB value. So far is similar, isn't it? Let's start interactive rendering. We don't have any reflections, so let's make it white. Let's copy the color correction map and plug it to the reflection glossiness slot. And now we'll be controlling the reflections by glossiness value. Okay, so I will use the same texture for the reflection glossiness map. I just make it much brighter. I will add this to the bump slot too. Okay, it looks nice. For the floor tiles, I will use stone textures from the CG source. Thanks to this, we will achieve more variations on the tiles. We can copy this material, but here we'll use a multi-texture map. Let's load the variations. We don't have to always use all variations. Here we go. All are loaded. Let's apply the material and start rendering. Cool, I like how it looks here. I won't be changing more settings. Next, we'll create a ceramic material for bath, toilet and basin. Let's select the objects and apply material. Let's make it white. Something around 180. Awesome. Turn on reflections by making them white. We can add a little glossiness too. 0.85 will be fine. We get nice reflections of light on the ceramic objects. For tap and accessories, we'll create a silver metal material. Create Vue material and make the color black. We'll select objects and apply the material to them. As this is one object, we can click 5 on the keyboard and select only the elements that should be metal and apply the material to them. We can do it one by one or select all and unselect this one. Now, let's change Fresnel IR to the maximum value. Let's add a bit of glossy. Now, by changing the reflection color, we can control the color of the metal. I'd like to make it a bit darker. Something like this will be fine. It's not so hard, right? Let's use this material also for pendants and mirror frames. Let's start with the pendant. I've already had the material assigned. It's multi-sub material, so I have light material on the bulbs and standard gray material for the rest. So let's plug the metal we've just created to the first slot. Nice. Okay, here is how it looks. I add the metal to the mirror frames. When you click 5 on the keyboard, it is the same as you will change it here. I select the frame polygons and apply the material to them. The same here. Now we'll create the material of the mirror. You can see that we have two separate multi-steps here. There is no need for this. Let's apply the material from this mirror to another one. Create VR material. Let's make the diffuse black. Turn off the Fresnel reflections. Glossiness value 1 means that it's perfectly clean. But I will add the surface imperfections textures. I really like to use it as it adds so much photorealism to the image. Plug it to the reflection glossiness slot. Be careful not to make it too strong. It's super easy to overdo this. To control this effect, we can decrease the amount value in this map step. 10 will be enough. We want this almost invisible. Let's add the stone material to other objects as well. Now we will create wood material for the panel on the wall. We'll use the same method as for the stone tiles. We'll use the wood panels from the CG source. Add bitmaps. Awesome. Let's see how it looks. Oh, I forgot to apply the material. This time we'll also add some random gamma value to make the brightness variations. This will make some panels darker and some brighter. Not too much. I think 0.2 will be enough. Next, we'll adjust the overall color using a color correction map. I like it to be less saturated and more towards reds. Yes, it's better. I use color correction again and create reflection glossiness and bump. Wood should have a more grayish color for reflections. We can decrease the amount of glossiness so it will become brighter as it mixed with white. These wood panels adds a lot of warmth to the space. It's really nice contrast with the cold stone tiles. We should have the stone material in one more place. Let's assign it now. We're almost done. Lastly, we'll add the simple wood material to the shelves. I drag and drop the bitmap and I plug it to the diffuse slot. Let's apply it here. And here as well. We can make the bitmap visible on the objects. Let's desaturate it and let's control the glossiness with the amount value. Reflect color to sort of gray. Maybe a bit less actually. Okay, I also have the normal map that we'll use as a bump texture. To make it work, we need to add the very normal map. and plug to the normal map slot, and finally to the bump slot. Awesome, we have the materials done for this scene. Of course, later on we'll need to add some more details and work on the post-production process. So, if you want to know how to set up the camera, create lighting, creating materials, add assets, and how to use the post-production process, I'd like to invite you to check out our visualization course, where we teach you step by step how to create beautiful images. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!